see the description about this, and then we'll prove how we got this, or how, why we consider this is the only solution for this equation. So let us take P and Q as two regular expressions over sigma. Sigma is nothing but the alphabet. Okay. So here, if P and Q are two regular expressions, and if P does not contain epsilon, okay, if this expression P, if it does not contain epsilon, then equation in R it is defined as. So then you are defining the equation as R equal to Q plus RP, and you are saying that this has unique solution. And what is that solution? It is R equal to QP star. Okay. So what is this? Here you are taking Q and P as two regular expressions. Okay, and you are saying that this R equal to QP star is the only solution for this R equal to QP. That means wherever we get any equation in the form of R equal to Q, Q plus RP, then you need to replace this equation with QP star. Right? So this is the concept of Hardin's theorem. So simply we can say that when the equation is in the form of R equal to Q plus RP, you need to replace that with QP star. Now let us see the proof. So let us take Q equal to RP as one expression. So take Q equal to, sorry, here it is R equal to Q plus RP. Let it be equation 1. And here what I told you, you need to substitute QP star in place of R. So let us substitute QP star in place of R. So it is Q into QP star P. Okay. So this can be written as Q plus P star P can be written as P star, and this is represented as Q into epsilon plus P star, which is nothing but QP star. So now let us take the equation R equal to Q plus RP, and here this way, here R should be replaced with QP star. So let us write this as Q into QP star P, which can be written as Q into epsilon plus P star P. So if any expression is in the form of epsilon plus R into R star, that should be written as R star. So apply same rule. So this is P into P star. So it can be written as P star. So your final letter. So here from this equation we got R equal to Q plus. So let us take the same equation. In place of R, instead of substituting this QP star, let us substitute same equation. Okay, write this as Q plus, in place of R, again write Q plus RP into P. So this can be written as Q plus QP plus RP square. Next again, in place of R, substitute same equation again. So you will get R equal to Q plus QP plus, in place of R, substitute Q plus RP and P square. So from this you will get Q plus QP plus QP square plus RP cube. Okay, and so on. So we can, if we write Okay. So every time when we substitute this equation in place of r, so it is an infinite thing. So you can't solve this. So let us see if by substituting this in this expression. So if you represent it for n, then it can be written as q plus qp plus qp square plus and so on plus qp power n plus r into p power n plus 1. Okay, let us take this equation as 3. Now, so we are unable to solve this equation without substituting qp star. Okay, that's what we proved here. Now, do one thing. In place of this r, substitute qp star. Okay, so now substitute r equal to qp star. See which expression you will get. It can be written as q into qp plus qp square plus and so on plus qp power n plus, in place of r, substitute qp star into p power n plus n. This can be written as, take this q common, epsilon plus p square plus and so on p power n plus p power n plus 1 into p star. Okay, so r equal to this expression. Again, take this q and this whole expression is in the form of epsilon plus p star p. So which can be written as, so if anything in the form of epsilon plus r star r, it can be written as r star. So this is one notation which we have, one rule. So this is in the form of epsilon plus, this complete thing can be taken as r star into r. So you will get r star, here we will get p star. So now we got r equal to qp star. So from this it is clear that this is the only solution for this equation. Okay, so what we did, initially we took r equal to qp and we just tried to solve this equation without using this notation by replacing r, the same value in place of r. Okay, now we got second equation. Again in place of this r, substitute same thing. From this we got this equation. And so on, we repeated the same thing till n. So that representation is given as third expression here. So as we are unable to solve this equation, now we took this r equal to qp star and in this final equation we substituted qp star in place of this r. Okay, so remaining thing we wrote it as it is. And now take this q as common. And this complete thing can be written as epsilon plus p square plus and so on p star into p power n plus 1. So this is in the form of epsilon plus r star r. Notation is r star. So as this is in that form, we are writing this as p star. So from this we got the expression as r equal to qp star.